wired into there, and I opened up the battery compartment, and okay, I don't know what's happening to the stream because I have strong signal. Anyway, I connected the Genasun lithium charger, which is what connects the solar cells to the battery. And on the battery, I took the cover off the bottom, and I just tested voltage where I was getting 36 volts, and I connected the wires to there. And this scooter already has a battery management system which balances the cells. So we're just utilizing that system to keep the cells in balance. And I'm just using these Elflan SP22s, which are monocrystalline solar cells. And as you can see, by being able to angle the cells by these clamps, which I have listed in the description, just loosening these and angling them. And this is just a hose here, thick hose, to act as a cushion and help grip when I tighten this. So you can see that the angle I'm at is directly facing the sun. I'm able to angle the solar cells to face the sun, which gives them maximum efficiency. So there it is. This is the Weihu Igo trailer, and we just had this welded on, and then another piece welded heat this way, and then these are like washers right here. And then this is aluminum, and it's welded. TIG welding was used to weld all the connections. So this is welded right here across the inside. And then this was welded. This comes across. It's welded across here on the other side, across here. This is where the plugs come out. So this was placed here and then welded here and here. As you can see, the panels are wired in series, which is positive to negative, and then positive and negative going to our watts up meter. And as you can see right now, the battery's already full right now, so it's not taking a lot of charge, but this is a watts up meter telling us how much power we're producing at the moment and how much the is actually being drawn by the load. So this is showing us the load. So it's not producing a lot of power right now. It's not receiving a lot of power right now because the battery's already full. But the voltage, what's nice about this Genasun is the Genasun is a voltage boosting. It boosts the voltage up to what's needed to charge the battery. So if I had another meter like this connected to the output, which I might do that, here, going from here to the battery. And again, the way I connected this to the battery was I just found a place where I was getting a reading of 36 volts on the battery, and I just soldered it to the battery. And so if I had a watts up meter connected between the Genasun and the battery, it would show us the proper voltage, the 41.7 volts. So this is showing that it's charging right now. So there it is. This is just a quick update video, just showing that this is working really well. And it's pretty lightweight too. I can pick up this whole trailer with one hand. And to this, we're gonna add the GVB-8 engine here in this area eventually. So we're still working on that. So these panels, what's nice about the Elflan, what I liked about the Elflan solar cells is the cells that we bought were not necessarily in perfect condition. You can see they have little chips and nicks on the edges, but the price was really good and they still produce great power. So I think these were just over $200 and they produce 160 watts. And these are monocrystalline cells. My understanding is that these cells, the way that these cells are grown, they're crystals. Monocrystalline is a single crystal, so it's one big crystal. Some cells, you look at them, you'll see a bunch of little crystals inside there, a lot of little crystals. This is just one big crystal. So monocrystalline is what we wanted to go with, and that's what we got. And they work very well. And monocrystalline is supposed to work really well in when it's cloudy or overcast. It's supposed to be more efficient. These cells are up to 24% efficient, which is very efficient. We added the Planet bike to the trailer. It didn't come with a mud guard or a fender, so we added this, and it's by Planet Bike, and it goes up, and it comes with these parts here, and we had a washer welded to here and here as a way of mounting this to this bolt here that goes across. So there it is, everyone. Unlimited range all day. Now, if you go full speed on the scooter, then this would just act as a range extender. But if I'm just going low speed, like for me, with my weight, if I'm going like under 10 miles an hour, because this scooter can go up to 15 miles an hour, which is pretty fast for what we're using it for. It's plenty fast for us. And if we're just staying under 10 miles an hour, just cruising along, we're not gonna use more power than those solar panels produce, so it can actually act as a range extender without end. It can just keep the battery charged. It can actually produce enough energy to keep the scooter going without depleting the battery. So, and then when the sun goes down, we're working on another system, a generator system, which is a 25-pound, and you can look into inverter generators, which weigh much less than the old style generators. An inverter generator, we found one that weighs 25 pounds, which is a 700-watt continuous Ryobi propane inverter generator. And we were thinking of using it just the way it comes, but I thought, why not try adding a GEET engine to it? Because I'm interested in the GEET technology and how it works and what it can do, and also in seeing for myself what it can do. So we thought this is a good time to integrate the two technologies into one transportation device, where we have the scooter powered by sunlight in the daytime, and then the scooter can possibly be powered by the GEET system at nighttime when the sun's not shining, or at least powered by the propane generator at night if needed. But we have the GEET system on it, and you can look at our videos on that. And we're gonna see what the GEET can do. We're interested in seeing what it can do. A lot of people have tested that system with great success, and we're interested in seeing for ourselves what it can do. So the free build plans are on GEET International, and you can read about what they have achieved, reducing emissions, producing oxygen from the exhaust, many anomalies that are quite interesting and can be quite beneficial to the environment and to humanity as a whole. Okay, everyone, True Zero Emissions here, signing off. Don't forget to like the video if you liked it, and please share your experiences with your experiments, and let us know what you're working on, because we learn from you. Okay, everyone, have a great day. Bye.